Hey everybody, trying to show you a very simple Nautilus shell and trident farm. So it's a very simple farm, it doesn't require a perimeter, but it's still decently efficient. So here you can already see what's happening. We have a drowned mob that naturally spawned, being attracted by a villager, tries to reach him, but just runs into our trap. We have some soul sand blocks here, and the drowned will get some upwards momentum. He shoots up, activates some string blocks in front of an observer, and then he's pushed into the portal of those pistons. And then the player can just afterwards go to the nether and kill the drowned mobs. So you need to kill the drowned mobs for player, otherwise they wouldn't drop any tridents. You could still get Nautilus shells if you automatically kill the drowned mobs, but you need to kill them with a player in order to get the tridents. Okay, you can also see that it's working. I think the tracking range is about 48 to 50 blocks. So you can see here this drowned mob here in the back that naturally spawned still tracks the villager and tries to reach him. Sometimes they get a bit stuck like this one here, but that usually resolves itself after about 5 to 10 seconds and then they make their way into the nether dimension. So we're now in the nether dimension. Most of the drowned mobs already fell down, and in order to take care of the rest, we have this little contraption here where we break the portal blocks, push the drowned mobs out, and then relight the portal. Alright, so you can see I spread this out, made a big portal just to avoid any issues with entity cramming. Alright, then you can easily take out the drowned mobs and hopefully get your trident. So it's not very likely to get a trident, there one dropped. So just 15% of the drowned mobs spawn with a trident, and then they have an 8.5% chance to drop that trident, which can be increased by 1% per level of looting. So you would need to kill 58 random drowned mobs in order to get one trident on average. Alright, then you have some hoppers, collected everything, and as you can see, you get some Nautilus shells. There's just a 3% chance to get one, or that a drowned mob would spawn with one. And yeah, we already have some tridents here. So this was kind of lucky. Got a few. I should also mention that converting zombies is no longer a viable option to get tridents. So I'm just gonna spawn a bunch in, but you will see none of those zombies drop their armor or change the weapons, so they just take over stuff they had previously as a zombie if they converted into a drowned mob. So previously, just having a zombie spawner then converting zombies was a viable option to make a drowned farm or a trident farm, but this no longer is really a viable option. Alright, so here we should see them converting any moment. Spin around. You can also maybe see the rare blue drowned mob. They're quite cool. So if a zombie has a enchanted helmet, then the drowned mob is purple. Okay, here we go. Got the first drowned mobs. And here we already have a purple drowned mob. So there's apparently a glitch when they wear enchanted helmets as zombies. Yeah, as you can see, this one is also purple. Kind of cool, I liked it, but it's probably not intended. Yeah, anyway, so as you can see, none of those converted zombies have a trident, and they would also not drop a trident. So there's no longer an option to just convert zombies. The area that I've chosen for the trident farm is a normal deep ocean biome. Deep ocean biome because it would have a huge amount of spawning spaces, so each water block would be a potential spawning space. Yeah, as you can see, drowned spawning is super slow, that's why you want as many spawning spaces as possible. Haven't done any preparation besides. The AFK spot is about 100 blocks above the farm in the sky, so we don't load too many mobs in caves. What I should have done, but haven't done yet, would be to light up the islands around it, since they're also in reach of the player, and I haven't lit up any caves, so this is something you could do as well in order to slightly improve the raids. But as you can see here, this is almost perfect already. So almost no caves around, so this is a really good spot for the trident farm. Alright, I want to do another 1 hour test just to see how much drowned mobs we get. So I'm gonna clear the nether side and then I'm gonna AFK for exactly 1 hour here and then we'll see how much drowned mobs we get. So that's the amount of mobs we got within an hour. And as you can see, it's even too much. It's already lose some because of entity cramming already. That's a bit of a shame, but we can maybe estimate how much we lost because of entity cramming. Seems like, oh god, we probably lost 60 drowned mobs because of that. Alright, nevertheless, let's break it and kill the rest of looting. Then we can maybe check out the statistics, how many mobs I have killed, drowned. Alright, let's remember that and let's see how much there was left. So I managed to kill 241 drowned mobs and we probably lost 60 due to entity cramming. So if you want to AFK for a longer time, then you probably need to rebuild the system a little bit. But it's just meant to AFK for maybe half an hour, 45 minutes and get a few tridents. It's not really an industrial farm. But you can obviously rebuild the nether system in order to not lose drowned mobs because of entity cramming. Alright, let's also check out what we got here. So unfortunately just got one trident this time, but yeah, luck is really the most important part here. In the first try, when we went to the nether, I got two more, way fewer mobs. So we were especially unlucky this time, but we got 12 Nautilus shells. And with a 3% drop rate, that's pretty good. Alright, let's head back to the overworld so I can show you how to build this. There's one more thing I want to mention. You can also use a turtle egg as a bait for the drowned mobs, but this has the disadvantage that the range is a lot lower. So if the villager drowned mobs from about 50 blocks would start walking towards the villager, but if the turtle egg is just about 20 blocks, so the range is a lot lower, but it's still, I think, a viable alternative. But the rates will be a lot lower, so it should be just a fourth or a fifth of the villager rate. So I would definitely recommend to use a villager. There might also be a possibility to use an iron golem. I tried that, I put him in there, but the drowned mobs didn't track him, so maybe I just got this wrong, but I would definitely recommend to just use a villager. So now I want to show you how you can build this. You need the following materials. So you need 12 pistons, 12 observers, 12 blocks that can be powered, 12 node blocks, 12 string blocks, 44 obsidian, 12 soul sand blocks, 4 cobble walls, and then also some glass blocks around it. 2 stacks should be enough. Then you also need a villager, a bucket would be good, some sponges would also be nice, and also some just general scaffolding blocks. It's also always good. All right, now let's start. So we start with the portal block, I would say. So search for a nice area, which is a deep ocean biome and relatively flat. Then you go up 5 blocks, 4, 5 water blocks in between, and you make the portal. So let's just 5 by 5 here, hole in the middle, then we go up 1, 2, 3, 4 and finish the portal shape. So now in order to light those portals up, we need to remove the water blocks and therefore make sure it's dry in here. I just go to the outside and place some blocks in front. Then also grab your sponge block and the flint and steel. Okay. Oops, forgot to place a block here. Okay, now let's light this up. Okay, and escape through the bottom. And now we can break those blocks again. Okay, then get the glass blocks again and we continue building walls. So we just keep one block open here at the bottom. This is enough for the drown pumps to pathfind through it. And it's also a good idea to get a cobble wall just to make sure that there's really no chance that a baby drowned could get inside. Right, do this for all four sides. So we covered all four sides. Also drain this area, the sponge. So like this. And now we want to get our villager inside of here. Probably it's a good idea to fill up the blocks here on the side. So the villager is nice and centered in the middle. So like this, we're gonna drop him down from the top. And therefore we get our disposable blocks and make a cross shape up to surface level. And then we just punch in a hole in the middle and drop down our villager. Should be clear, you can get the villager to the ocean biome either with a flying machine or with some rain. So villager will fall down and is trapped in the middle. Exactly what we want. Alright, I'm just gonna get one in. If you don't have a villager, obviously you can also use the turtle egg and just place it in the middle. It should also be fine. But the range is lower. Also tried again with the iron golem, couldn't get it to work. So it seems like the drowned don't track the iron golem like they do with villagers. So now let's just go up four blocks like this and place some blocks here on the side. Now get your piston, node block, blocks can be powered, and observers. If you don't have node blocks, but yeah, you should have node blocks, you could also use pistons instead. It's just to send a signal to the piston. Alright, then get the observers as well. The block that can be powered. Alright, then here we try to close this off. Get a sponge. And make this dry. Then get your string. And can already get the bucket. Oh, I forgot to place a block here on top, apparently. Oh, this wasn't dry. Yeah, get your string and place it in front of the servers. So like this, and fill up this section again with water up to the obsidian blocks. Alright, then next get soul sand, place it here in front. Then we're just gonna fill up the side here just to guide the mobs a little bit so they don't try to pathfind towards the villager on a diagonal. So they should go around this. Alright, then you just need to continue with this for all four sides. And then it should already look like this. Let's also take a look at the Nether. So I would definitely recommend to kill all the drowned mobs every 45 minutes or so. So you don't have any issues with entity cramming, but also you don't have any lag issues. So if you would AFK for multiple hours, then you would be welcomed by thousands of drowned mobs, which could lag your game severely. So it's definitely not a good idea to keep them or to pile them up over longer time than that. And if it works like my farm, then you should get your tridents also within 45 minutes, you don't AFK overnight for this. In case you want to really have thousands of drowned mobs, then you need to rebuild this a little bit. But yeah, it's getting a bit tricky as well. Alright, but anyway, in case you're interested in this little contraption that helps pushing out the last drowned mobs, it's not really that necessary since most of them push themselves out and then they also start walking, but it's still nice. So let's take a look at this. We have a double row of pistons. This is 15 long because of the signal strength 15. In one corner there's a dispenser with a lava bucket in it, and the other corner dispenser with some flint and steel. Here we just press a button for a sticky piston observer monostable, then we power this block, Then we take an output of a repeater on 3 ticks of server below, powers a block which powers the dispenser and also powers the sticky piston with the downwards facing observer, which when it retracts powers the redstone dust line, and then here take another output of the observer, powered rail, another observer here, and then we trigger the dispenser. Okay, I use two observers here to get enough delay so there's enough time to push out the mobs. So one more note, in case you're playing on a server and there are other players in another dimension, it might happen that your drowned mobs get despawned, even if the players are far away. Reason is, when the drowned mobs go through the portal in overworld dimension, then the whole portal linking process starts. It loads 17 by 17 chunks, and this also makes this chunky entity processing, and mobs in entity process chunks get despawned if there are other players in the same dimension. It's a bit difficult, but there's even a workaround for this. You could make an offset of the linked portal, so you're basically in the lazy chunks of the 17 by 17 loaded chunks. It's a bit tricky, but I just wanted to mention it. It's a bit much for this video. Maybe I'll make a separate video about this topic at some point.